Welcome back to Switch Corner. It's time for my weekly look at deals across the Nintendo eShops for the US, Canada, UK, EU and AU. Now as always, this one, it is any price goes, meaning expect to part with some cash. If you want cheaper, I'd suggest checking out my Thursday weekly edition where I keep everything, you know, sub $10 or your local currency. Now with that, as always, I do have my weekly giveaway winners to announce. That's going to be to win one of two $10 eShop gift cards. I'm going to be doing that as we go through today's list. As always then, like we're doing that same thing again this week, all you need to do to enter, it's simple, drop a comment down below and I'll announce the winners next week. With that, look, get comfy. This one, it's a longer list than normal. We've got 16 games for you today, so just, yeah, settle in. And before we get started, look, hit subscribe if you love the Switch, as much as we all do here. Join our growing family. If just 150 of you do that after watching this, we'll get to that 10k mark, so thank you all so much. Let's get started. Kicking things off then this week, we've got Children of Zodiacs coming in with 25% off. This is one I was actually supposed to review on the channel and I just never kind of got round to it, so here is my chance. Basically, I really enjoyed it though. It just took me a little longer than I anticipated to get it finished because it took me like a good 20 hours. But yeah, with this one, it's basically turn-based strategy with RPG mechanics and even some like tabletop gaming thrown in for good measure. It's really cool though and I love the story too. You're basically this like group of thieves that are after an ancient relic and you'll be trying to escape the, let's say, less than friendly locals. So think like a psychotic family, gangs, the army, cannibals. This one though, it's just really unique. You'll be utilizing like cards for combat and then rolling dice for bonuses. It is an acquired taste, but I was really impressed and it's a beautiful game too. This world is one that just though hooked me immediately and just kept me locked in for the entire playtime. Next up then, I've spoken about it before, but with a new all-time low price, we've got Fury Unleashed. Coming in with 40% off, it's a great price for this like run and gun platformer that meets, you know, roguelite. Basically, when you die, it's back to the beginning, but with more skill points and some additional perks. What really separates out though, like Fury Unleashed, it's actually the visual style, because here it's all set within the pages of a comic book. So you start at the top of the page, and then you've got to like move around the cells to find the exit in the bottom right. You can go any direction you want though. Expect here tons of enemies, challenging difficulty, multiple comic book issues to battle your way through. But then I gotta say also a surprisingly good story that almost like dives into the psyche of the person who created this fictional comic book. It really was a nice surprise, this one, that I absolutely recommend, especially if you have the option to play in local co-op. That is where it absolutely shines. So a couple of quick ones now, mainly because you're gonna need to move quick. The rest of today's list for the most part lasts a full week. These have maybe a few days remaining. First up though, Atomy Crops. This one is coming in with 20% off. And yes, it's the smallest discount on today's list, but it is also one of the newer games. The tagline though, honestly, had me intrigued from the beginning. Farm, marry, kill. The idea is simple enough though. Combine farming mechanics with roguelike gameplay, where basically you'll be battling mutants, protecting your crops, selling your goods, upgrading your equipment, and then even, as the tagline suggests, getting married in this like post-apocalyptic world. It's not perfect, mainly in its like lack of any real guidance, but once you get the hang of it, it is worth a look and definitely tries something new with the genre. So also expiring on the 4th, then we get the Alliance Alive HD Remastered. This one, it's an RPG that was basically released originally on the 3DS, but it's found its way to the Switch thanks to NIS America. And I think it's actually fair to say it's one of their best releases so far. Here, they took the core game though and threw in, you know, new visuals, a new interface, some control adaptations. But yeah, it transitions really smoothly across to the Switch and it's a great way now to play. Spearheading though a revolution against demons has never felt so good, and 40% off, absolutely just worth it. Okay, so here's an interesting one for you. Each week I always name a few games I've never played but I'm picking up, so I can't necessarily, you know, recommend them. That said, this is one I picked up on a video a couple of months back, and now I'm willing to say consider it. This game, it's Fambrace Cold Soul, a game that absolutely split audiences out there, with reviews ranging from like 4 out of 10 all the way up to 9 out of 10. I personally enjoyed it. Not perfect, sure, and it's a hell of a difficult game, there's no question about that. But if you like roguelike turn-based combat, give it a go, or at least check out a few reviews and see if it's gonna be for you. 50% off though right now makes it the best price it's ever been. I wouldn't go like full price personally, but I think this is more than fair. So this one's real cheap. It's called Metalloid Origin, and I took a gamble on it because it was insanely cheap to begin with. But yeah, now it's 30% off, making it like a steal in my opinion. It's basically a Mega Man clone, and at this price, you can't really complain. Solid controls, some fun worlds, 9 levels, 3 characters to play as, a few difficulty options. It's really all you need. No Mega Man, of course, don't get me wrong, but as clones go, it is one of the better ones I've played. So before we do get to the first winner of the week, then it's not the best racer, but we have two, you know, bike racers on sale right now. We've got Monster Energy Supercross 2 and MXGP 3. Whatever you do, do not spend your cash on MXGP 3. To put it nicely, it's a bit of a disaster and one of the first reviews I ever did on this channel, and I gave it a 3 out of 10. Watching that back for this video, I will say was an awful experience. That said, like, Monster Energy Supercross 3 was a great jump in quality, but 2, the one that's on sale right now, it's not bad at all when you throw in the fact there's a 70% discount. Decent selection of tracks, pros, custom track editor, online races. I did a seriously in-depth review on this one and I'll pin it in the description below. But if you absolutely must buy one of these two, this is the way to go. MXGP 3, I wouldn't even suggest you if it was free. I'd say just save that card space. So our first winner of the week then, congratulations to Troy Perry, who said he loves the videos, which I absolutely appreciate, and asked if I'm digital over physical. And I'll tell you this, absolutely not. I'll always take physical first when I can, and I have a decent sized collection actually. You can see it in the Games Room tour I did like late last year. That said though, look, there's some serious gems on the eShop that never get physical and I love to explore it. So yeah, that kind of led to all of this. Drop me an email though, the address is in the description below, and of course, congrats again. So fight fans, everyone was screaming about this one on Thursday's video, but Blazblue CENTRALFICTION, and what a masterpiece this is. For me, it's the best fighter on the Switch hands down, and pretty much the main reason I picked up a arcade fight stick. This is also a seriously steep discount though, coming in with 60% off, and this is like the lowest it's ever been. Content wise, you just can't beat this game though. Tons of modes, think like, you know, your usual versus, online, single player arcade, but then this even has like a single player story mode that's basically a visual novel. The story is going to be tough to follow though if you've never played any previous entries, but still, it's a great price and absolutely worth a look. This week on sale too, Dragon Ball Fighterz though, if that's more your thing. I picked CENTRALFICTION though because this isn't the first time we've seen Dragon Ball with 75% off. I doubt it's going to be the last. Alright, so my pickup of the week then, and I saw a few comments about this one on Thursday's video. This is the Warlock of Firetop Mountain. As always, I can't recommend it, never played it, but it's got great reviews and it's currently like a monster 90% off. This one though, I will warn now, it seems from what I can tell an acquired taste. Basically, it's tabletop role-playing adventure that seems to owe a lot to Warhammer. Looking forward to checking it out though. If you've played it, do let me know in the comments below, and even if you're going to try it out and join me for the ride, let me know that too. So before I get to our second winner of the week then, and the final two games of today's list, we've got basically a new all-time low here for you. Dead in Finland, coming in with 33% off. This is a turn-based RPG with survival and management elements. I think what appealed to me initially on this one was the visuals. It clearly like owes a lot to Banner Saga, but it didn't disappoint in gameplay either. Look, if you fancy an epic Viking tale, this is a real good place to look. Lot to like with this one, and it seems it's never destined for a huge price drop, so this may be, you know, a good time to jump in. So our second winner of the week then, John DX, I hope I said that right dude, but he's going to be checking out Steins Gate, and I really hope you did, because they're absolutely incredible. Well worth the cash they were asking in that sale. With that though, look, thank you again to everyone that commented, it means a lot to me. Remember to drop a quick comment below this week for your chance to win, and then hit subscribe so you're notified the second that video goes live next Saturday. So our penultimate game of the week, and it's an unusual one for sure, but I think it's cool. KORG Gadget for the Nintendo Switch. It's not really a game, but more like an app slash toy for budding musicians. And it's something I actually gotta say, I jump into quite a bit. It's got this interesting mechanic where it combines like music and creation with gamification. I wish you could export more from it, but yeah, get together with friends and collaborate in this really unique take on like a digital audio workstation. Not a lot else I can say honestly, it's about as niche as they come, but sales they're not frequent, so if it's your jam, a tidy 30% off right now. So last up for the week then, one of my favourite games on the console, especially for my Switch Lite, that is Darkest Dungeon, which is a brutally difficult 2D roguelite, turn-based RPG experience. That's a lot of words for a descriptor. But anyway, look, what got me into this initially was a stunning hand, like, drawn gothic style, but what kept me coming back to this thing was just that it kept on kicking my ass on repeat, and I have that personality where it just kind of motivates me to get through it. Don't like challenge? Do not come here. Tons to do though, loads of dungeons, great characters that you'll actually care about, multiple classes to experiment with, great enemies too. Very little I dislike with this one outside of it's not as popular as it should be because there's a steep learning curve. 40% off though, it matches the lowest price ever. Buy it if you want a challenge, and maybe also check out all the discounted DLC too. That said, look, US, Canada, we don't get this, but everywhere else there's also what's called the Ancestral Edition, and it basically bundles in all the DLC, and that has a solid discount right now too, so maybe take a look there. And that's it, another week down. Congrats again to our winners. I appreciate you all watching, liking, and subscribing. A special shout out then to the patrons who are just going, you know, above and beyond to support Switch Corner. It means a lot to me, so thank you all so much. I am going to be adding a whole lot more content over there in the next like month, so if you want to check that out for yourself, I've put the link in the description below. Then finally, look, if you're new here, hit subscribe if you love the Switch as much as we all do here. Join our growing family, and I'll see you all on the next video. Thanks everyone.